So this is my lighting system for my bike. See, like, this is just a waterproof switch. It's literally a switch. I just use it as a tail light for a bonus. Press the button, headlight comes on. Motorcycle light from, I got like $7 on eBay. It's also waterproof. This is also waterproof. It's a USB charger and a voltmeter, so I can tell the voltage of my battery. And then I just charged it. And right now I'm installing hand warmers for the winter. I got these from a old hair straightener. I'm putting these in here. I just tested it out. The best way to wire them up is not in like series, but like that, basically, both of them. And then I'm just wiring it up, drilling a couple holes, and then I'm gonna seal that up with rubber cement probably. And then alright, so I got this line here now all hooked up, heat shrink together and shit. This is just tin foil on here, so it fits snugly in there, and then it transfers the heat like properly. It's gonna go down in there like that, and then obviously the wires run through here. That's the best way I could think of to get past the gear shifter. I just fucking drill a hole, two holes, and boom. Hopefully it works as I plan it to. Alright, so I just got done installing them. This is a 12-volt battery, by the way, but I just turned them on. They're warm now. It's pretty cold outside. I don't know. It's probably like in the 50s or something. The metal is warm now. It's just warm to the touch. It's staying around 12.1, 12 volts. Normally it's around 12.4, 12.5. That one's heating up. And now they're starting to heat up a lot more. That's pretty cool. That's a good idea. I like this idea. That was a good idea. Yeah, if you got a pair of old, like a hair flat iron things, you want to get one of those ones with the skinny things on it, not the ones that are like that wide. You want to get ones that are like have that long of a bar that heats up, and then you just basically take it apart and you wrap aluminum foil around it, or tin foil, whatever you want to call it, and then you get it nice and snug in there so the heat transfers to the handlebars. Wow, they're getting nice and toasty. Oh yeah. The red one's getting a little bit more hot, but they're about the same though. I put the on and off switch right here. It's just one of those old school switches. It's on and off. It's on right now. I push it down, turn it on, pull it up back up for off. Staying right around 12 volts. The battery probably won't last as long with the light on and stuff. I'll put the light on right now. Probably go back down to like 10 volts or some shit. I'd be surprised if it didn't. I was thinking I could reverse charge the battery, and then I'll get an extra volt out of it when I recharge it the proper way. I mean, that's what I've seen on YouTube anyways. But yeah, it's done.